Researchers from UCLA have created a prototype that creates electricity from snowfall. They call it a snow-based triboelectric nanogenerator, or Snow-TENG. Snow-TENG. Snow-TENG? Snow-TENG. That's what they call it. You check out that prototype I just made? Ain't Snow-TENG. Essentially, the prototype seems like an interesting energy harvesting application that generates charge through static electricity and produces energy from the exchange of electrons. Right now, the Snow-TENG can produce an open circuit voltage up to 8 volts, and it is designed to work like a self-powered weather station to monitor snowfall, accumulation depth, wind direction, and speed in snowy or icy conditions. Basically, snow is positively charged, silicone is negatively charged, and when falling snow contacts the surface of silicone, it produces a charge, and the device captures that charge, creating electricity. According to the researchers, it could be particularly useful in areas that have a tendency to render solar panels useless. About 30% of the Earth's surface is covered by snow each winter, and during that time, solar panels often fail, because snow accumulation reduces the amount of sun that reaches the arrays. The team 3D printed the prototype, which includes a layer of silicone and an electrode to capture the charge. Because silicone is widely available and 3D printing is relatively low cost, the researchers believe that it could remain fairly low cost to produce. And because the sensor is so small, it also has big potential in the wearable market. Ain't Snow-TENG. Researchers from Purdue University have discovered a way to improve drone maneuverability with new arms inspired by insects. If you've ever flown a drone in the wind or subtle breeze, you know that a little bit of wind can cause a lot of problems that stem from the drone's fixed arm design. So the team of researchers designed and patented a drone with arms that automatically fold to make in-flight adjustments. According to the researchers, it was inspired by the wings and flight patterns of insects, though they didn't share any specifics on the species. Guess that's proprietary or something. Oh, it likely is. The folding arms make it possible to change the center of gravity in flight, which also increases the drone's stability and efficiency. The technology could also make it possible for drones to carry heavier payloads. In the future, the new arms could be useful for search and rescue drones because they can morph to fit through narrow spaces and help navigate harsh and unpredictable airspace. Next, the team is looking for additional researchers as well as potential partners to license the technology. Ain't Snow-TENG. Back in June 2016, Boston Dynamics introduced the world to the Spot Mini, a smaller version of the Big Dog that was more geared to the consumer industry. The thought was that it could perform up to 90 minutes of chores on a single charge, doing everything from loading the dishwasher to, because America, fetching snacks. Over the last 2 years, the robot dog has received some upgrades and, according to the company, has begun production. Now that Spot is preparing to come trotting off that production line, Boston Dynamics wanted to show off some of the robot's capabilities, doing so in dramatic fashion that seems to be a particular skill for the company. Boston Dynamics tethered 10 Spot robots together and had them pull a box truck across the company's parking lot in Massachusetts. At first, I thought the footage of them just passing by was eerie. Then I saw the footage of them simultaneously rising, beginning to pull. The two Spot Minis in the lead include an arm attachment that adds 5 degrees of freedom, as well as about 11 pounds to the frame, and each pup has a sensor suite that helps it navigate. Now, what I found interesting was that they are numbered anywhere from 5 to 29, which just makes me wonder, what happened to the missing 19 dogs? It's like a puppy mill out there, just a mass grave or scrap heap of, you know, versions that just weren't up to snuff. Oh my God, I bet that's what's in the back of the truck. While the company claims that Spot is in production, a price hasn't been made public and the website doesn't contain any information on potential pre-orders. I'm David Manti. This is Engineering by Design.